Never mind that. What is the news?
We have been annihilated in Ireland, Your Grace. Tyrone surprised us. Sir William Bagnall is dead. Every company, troop, arms, stores, everything utterly destroyed.
Wars, death, famine in that unhappy land. And for what? For a few miserable acres of fever-smitten bog, and a few handfuls of tattered peasants whose only desire is to be left in peace to cut each other's throats. Well, they may. I'll put an end to it. Not another man goes to Ireland.
You can no longer ignore it. What do you suggest, my lord?
Either a drastic increase in our present taxes or a series of additional taxes.
The country will not endure it.
Lords, let us leave this question. Any further business before us?
There is one perpetual subject, Your Majesty, which we take up time after time and always leave unsettled. Tyrone's rebellion in Ulster. It's no longer a smoldering coal, it's a running fire spreading north to south.
Which means?
Men, money, ships.
You at least should be merry. I hear you've been attending the theater.
No, madam.
But you did forbid the performance of Richard II by Master Shakespeare and his players without consulting me. Why?
The play is treasonous, Your Majesty. It shows the dethronement of a king.
What then? Are my people so easily led that they would run from the theater to pull their queen out of her chair? Who is there here fears a rebellion against me? Not myself, certainly.